Hello, everybody. It's Friday. Shout out, shout out, shout out. And welcome to my web series here on YouTube. And you also catch me on my website. We're going to do something a little different today. So we have Miss Kimbrew, a.k.a. Tell them your name.
Chocolate Virgo.
So on probably pretty much on Thursdays or Fridays, we'll have a Keeping It Real with Chocolate Virgo. So what I call her is the guru of sex. Why? Because she thinks of some crazy shit when it comes to sex. So I'm not what you call a freak. And I'm not going to act like I'm a freak. And I'm not even going to try to be a freak. So I'll consult the freak expert. So she's going to speak her mind and how she feels. I'm behind the camera today. So you'll get two postings from me. One, Chocolate Virgo. And then the second one from me. So, the background, that song is called Straight Fucking. I thought that was the Baby Boy soundtrack from Tyrese. But that shit is from some old head group. And that shit is fine. That is some get your shit in the mood right type of shit. So, give me about 2 seconds and then we gonna get it cracking. We gonna leave it at straight. Because you know what it is after that. So, no interruptions at all. So, hello, Miss Chocolate Virgo. How are you?
How are you? How are you out there? Oh, the world.
Now, mind you, she just got this notice this morning that she was gonna do this. So, she like slick tie, slick what the hell am I gonna ask and all this shit. So, just know this is gonna be a great and funny ass interview. So, we're gonna start with question number one. What defines you to be a sexual guru?
Well, sexual guru. I can't say an expert because there's things I have not done and will not do. But if it gives you the tingles, got you sweating to where the sweat about to drop in your eye meat, and your body heart pumping, and you go in there and make a sandwich and make him some tea and to eat that. You got 15 minutes rejuvenation time. That's good sex.
Well, all
right then. Right there, I think would make me a sexual guru because I have different ways to make sure that I and my significant other gets what we got to get and more. Next question.
Now, you know she being tame. Let's just put this out here. So I don't know if
We gotta warm up here.
I don't know if I'm gonna have to put this under the 18 plus category or the general category. So I don't know yet. We gonna see how this goes once the editing process go through.
Yes.
Okay. Second question. We're gonna go ahead and get into the meat of things. What is the difference? Since she's from California, what is the difference between Memphis lovers and California lovers?
Ooh. Okay, shout out to the LA. Shout out to the LA. But first, the difference between LA and Memphis lovers. If an LA man says he wants just sex, that's what he wants. Memphis men or women, I don't know, whatever folks are both, have a tendency to not say what they want. When they get what they want, they get scared of it. It's scary. And run. But then, when you finally leave them alone, I do want you. I apologize for my transgressions. Please don't leave me alone. Then, when you give them another chance, they full of shit. So basically, if you're here in Memphis, and you want a lover, a good lover, I suggest, and I may be just biased, go outside of the state. Mississippi, Atlanta, Alabama, Arkansas, you know, a couple of California in there, whatever. But Memphis for Memphis ain't what's popping. Next question.
So basically what you're saying, Memphis lovers ain't what's popping in the street right now.
No.
Damn. So, all you Memphis men, step your game up. Hot topics.
No, mine. Because.
Okay. So.
No.
When did you fake your first orgasm? And how bad was the faking?
Sidebar. I might not be able to answer that question. Next question.
Oh, damn. No.
Next
on the web series, we shoot it from the hip in the dome. You ain't got to main names. You can change the situation to meet the need, but you got the...
What happens if you don't know or remember if you've ever faked the orgasm? What if you stopped the whole situation before because you saw what you saw wasn't what you wanted it to be?
That's a keep it real answer.
Okay. So, there has been times where I have faked, but an orgasm I can't fake because orgasms are few to come by for all women. You know, having a, or quote unquote coming, is something that's normal. An orgasm, that's when you got somebody speaking tongues and sheets start coming off the bed, but you still on the mattress. You know, and you know, you sweating, and it's 16 degrees in the house. That's orgasmic. But that's not what's going to happen at all times. I mean, that's normal. So I have faked it, but they don't know.
Damn, she not going to give us anything. Fuck.
They don't know. Well, when I can say
when
that.
When they look back, they're going on.
I have faked at least once in Memphis.
Damn, that sucks. So all you Memphis men that are very few in between that have dealt with Romula, I hope your game was tight. Because if not, nigga, she's talking about you. She's talking about you. And that's why she came with you. Go away. No. You.
Next question.
Okay, so toys.
Oh, sorry.
Flashbacks. So, do you feel like it's essential to have a toy in bed with your lover, or you bring yourself to a better climax without your lover?
First, I feel this is essential that you have one in the bed with you at all times, because it be times where you do not have that penis right next to you, and you be a little horny, you by yourself, you know, about chicka wow wow, and you just, you know what I'm saying, and you gotta go ahead and take care of your own self. So therefore, you know what I'm saying, if it's not in the bed with you, at least be able to, in arm's reach, you know what I'm saying. You're supposed to always have the vibrator slash dildo, the lube, and the extra Duracell or Energizer batteries. Shut up. But anyway, say it's essential, but if a woman knows her body, that's a shout out to Memphis women, you need to know your bodies. If a woman knows her body and she knows that he is not doing enough, or he is doing enough, or she wants to be overly stimulated just so she be able to get to that next level, then hey, I think it's essential. But it's also in the way you bring it up to him.
That's true.
You can't just be like, dun, 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 dun.
Dick power.
You can't be Star Wars and just expect him to just love it. No.
Damn.
You know, I mean, bring it to him in a sensual way. I want to show you something, and I want you to tell me how you feel about it. Or, I'm bored with playing with myself. Can you do it? I mean... You know what I'm saying?
Alrighty then.
Spice it up. You know what I'm saying? That. It might be time you don't want no of them. You just want him to play with the motherfucking pussy. Let him play with it. But tell him how to do it first. Then, most times, they will enjoy it.
A lot more than you.
A lot more than you. And especially if you tell them, you know, I'd like to see you stroke yours while you play with mine. That's talent. Plus, his hands on. And it's a happy day for everyone.
Yes. She's making this sound like an after school special.
Okay. Oh, fun sex is always great.
Oh my God.
Next question.
Oh Lord, I'm trying not to laugh, y'all.
Yeah, this is going to be 18 and over. Yeah.
Y'all know how I am. I promise you. This girl done had me laughing so goddamn hard I'm bursting into tears. This is hilarious.
But the point is, all I say is true. Next question.
Damn. Okay, so we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna say some things that, you know, might hit a little people the wrong way. Why do you feel, what, no, how can I put this? I'm not sure if you're familiar with the epidemic in Memphis when it comes to people actually walking around with the stuff called nasty people diseases. And yeah, we're going to go a little sensitive real quick. If you was a person trying to do a PSA and you know with everything you know about sex, what would be the one thing you would warn girls in Memphis, since you reside in Memphis now, what would be the...
Buy your own condoms. Even if it, you know what I'm saying? No, buy your own condoms. They got some nice ones out there. They got the ecstasies. They feel like there's nothing there. They got them in the regular size and what I call the gold foil size.
Damn. The golden foil.
If you feel weird about it, take your ass to Walmart, Walgreens, by yourself, buy them jokers. You know what I'm saying? Get you one of them little pocket mirrors or something, slip that mess in there. And then, you know what I'm saying? If you just, you scared to bring it up to them, make it a game. Put that joke in your mouth and suck his dick with it in your mouth. Next question.
Yeah, it's going to be 18 plus. Okay, so we're going to go one more question with that and then we're going to move on. Name five things that you think women need to do to make sure that they're being, one, sexually aware, and two, making sure that whoever they sleep with is safe. What are the top five questions per se? Because I have my top five, but I want to hear from your perspective. Need me to do mine first?
I would say, one, who are you staying with? Question is, do you have a girlfriend slash
boyfriend?
Because see, this is the thing about that right there. I have no problem with my friends who love dick as much as I do, meaning men. But if you are dating a man who likes men also, one thing about that,
that's a serious issue.
Because if a man can get better head than I can,
that's it.
That's a problem with me. That means that you can be at home with your man, turn around, baby, how you do this? Well, let me tell you how to do it, fish. That's just not going to do. No. So the first thing is ask him if he got a significant other, boyfriend, girlfriend, whatever.
What's your situation?
What, you know what I'm saying? What you doing when you ain't around me?
There it is.
You know what I'm saying? Two, have you ever
engaged in those activities?
You know what I'm saying? Do you know what I'm saying? Or you can be brutal like me. Do you like penis? I mean, you just can be brutal like that. Sometimes people don't take it right. But the thing is, brutal honesty is always what?
Honesty. Yeah.
So,
I got one for you.
Why are you trying to get in my apartment so quick after you just met me 5 minutes later? That's if you just met the dude and he trying to get up in your house. You don't know, he might got creepy crawlies on his little pubic balls, and I'm just saying, you might want to watch that.
You ain't lying.
If y'all already getting into the mood and you smell an odor that ain't Johnson & Johnson baby powder, you might want to watch it. If it ain't sweat.
Ugh. I don't want that.
Sweat, really, you really don't want that either.
Thank you.
So I would say you might want to make sure they take a shower before.
Or make it an activity.
Oh, you know what I'm saying? But sour privileges, they got to work on. You don't just get sour privileges when you first.
That's shower. True. No. You can't pass you know out the together you showers.
No. You know what I'm saying? They got to work up to them.
The shower together activities is momentous.
Right. You got to work up to them.
Yeah,
I agree. What I'm saying? So, you know what I'm saying? You know, but at the same time, you can't just throw him some old wash towel. Talk about him. You know what I'm saying? If you that worried about it, you know what I'm saying? If that just
wash
need
yourself.
Him to take a shower, go on, put the shower on for him and tell him, I'll wash your back.
Damn. I got one for you haven't mentioned yet. Make sure they have been tested.
Yes.
Make sure you've been tested. Because you could be walking around with some, damn it, I'll bite you. And nobody will know.
Bitch,
real hard.
Yes. But the main thing is don't go off of what you think.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? I mean, you can't.
That's self-explanatory, though.
You just can't. Also, watch if he said that I want to give you a baby. Watch that. Because that might be the one that either got some or he got about 18 of them motherfuckers coming out. And then also, bam, you got three of them in your uterus. Next question.
Damn. I'm sorry, this shit is funny as hell. This heifer is a crazy ass comedian. If you ever, I ever can get her on tape to do a full comedy spat, I promise you, you're gonna laugh for damn life. Oh, excuse me. We're also gonna go into what do you feel like that you lack as a mate and as a lover?
Oh, that's easy.
Okay.
I personally.
Mm-hmm.
And I feel this way, and I have no problem feeling this way, because in the other ways, I make up for it. I'm not the best writer. I don't like it. I'm not the best writer. I haven't had any complaints. I don't know if they're being nice or they just don't complain.
Damn.
But I personally don't like to do it. I'll try it. I'll do it.
Your booty too big to ride.
That might be the reason, but I don't like it. And I will do it, and I'll do it as long as I am interested. But once I lose interest, I'm going to need you to go ahead and flip that over, flip that rubber down, slap that ass. I'm going to want a doggy style. Next question.
This damn fool right here. My God. Last question, and we're going to close out because I'm going to laugh my ass off if I don't. Okay. Any advice? Do you have any advice for our YouTube viewers about, you know, about sex and how to be more comfortable in their body? And what's your status? Are you single, married, divorced? Doing you right now? It's complicated. All that shit. I'm just saying.
It's complicated. I'm doing me right now. There's someone there. I'm not by myself, but I'm doing me.
That was a whole lot of shit just skipping out on the question. So let's just put it out there.
Well, I have someone. I'm nervous about it. It's a new thing, but it's an old thing. So it's something out there, but it won't be confirmed until it's confirmed.
Hmm. Okay, and with that, we're going to end with this. Thank you, Miss...
Chocolate Virgo.
There it is. Chocolate Virgo. Thank you for your time. You is crazy as fuck. And if you ever want to see her do a comedic style, she'll have to come back probably at the beginning of the year when I can get her to loosen up enough to crack some jokes. Because this health is crazy. Lord have mercy. Or we can start a blog series called Tales of Candy Apples. And just tell you all the shit that be going on.
Candy Apples starring in Pancakes of Wild.
I'll clue y'all in later on what the hell Candy Apples starring Pancakes and Waffles really mean. Because that's some funny shit. This your girl, Tanisha Pie Size Diva. Thank you for tuning in to the web series. And Friday, shout out, shout out, shout out. So you have anybody you want to shout out to?
All those who like round of applause, please make your booty clap. Psh, psh.
Oh, Lord. Okay, virtual.
That is the greatest song playing on this radio right now. Everyone should know that song by heart.
Who would have learned Make It Booty Clap from the beginning all the way to the end?
Remember, the name of the song is Round of Applause by Waka Flocka Flame. What the hell is Waka Flocka Flame for? Is it burning? Is he burning?
Oh, shit. Next topic. We can't talk about that. They'll block my shit off YouTube. Welcome to my web series. Catch you next week. Peace.